Good morning, everybody. Good morning, grandmas. We haven't done vlogs in a long while. Actually, fun stuff's happening in my life now. I'm not just chilling in Midland, so I'm gonna try to do some vlogs. Monday vlog instead of a Monday. I'm staying in Austin at the Bonafide Hustler's house. This is his guest bedroom. Sheets are all torn up. I apologize. But I just did a contest on Instagram. They had the choice of a Polo high-tech bucket hat or the Polo high-tech climb hat, and they chose the climb hat. Instagram story, we did a comment picker, and it went like that. Underdog underscore rising won the contest, so congratulations. Hector, you're gonna get that climb hat right there. And I am also shipping out the Patagonia Cop at Cost. Finally, it was copped a couple days ago, and I'm finally shipping that out. This is what we're here for. This is the Brompton Black Edition M6 folding bicycle. I haven't showed it on YouTube yet, but I picked it up from a pawn shop. The Instagram people saw it.
So what's with all the wheels? So
when it folds, you can drag it. It's got the wheels. I paid $180 out the door, and their REI is like $1,500.
Really?
And the resale is like $1,200, $1,300 maybe. It's got some scratches
internal
on
hub.
Yeah, internal hub, three-speed, and then the two rear cogs, so it's a total of 6-speed. Everything's so tight on it. And of course, because I brought the folding bike to Austin, it's proprietary Brompton everything, and they have like...
Don't break anything.
Yeah, don't take it on a tour, because you'll never be able to find any of the parts, which is why I'm not going to take this on bike tour. But look at this, it's got like the little Brompton details of folding the bike there. Brompton details, but it has the pawn shop sticker. They were asking $250. I asked them what's the lowest they could do, even though they had 200 into it. That ARRZRR is a Cash America code for $200, by the way. That means what they have into it. You can tell on the sticker.
Yeah. You know what's scary is that you are relying on this, right? Like these two things to just hold up your entire weight.
Is that scary?
Yeah, it's pretty scary.
Billy, come here.
So it's just got a single chainring in the front. There's two cogs in the back and then a 3-speed internal hub. I'm gonna try to flip it here in Austin for over 1,000 within a week. Hopefully.
It feels kind of weird, like ergonomically. Are you gonna slide
that back? Well, you can shift that back. Yeah. I mean, I didn't put it there. It just that's how it was from when I bought it. And even these feel weird ergonomically, like they should be shifted forwards. But
I mean, that's fine. The ride's cool, except that it feels like I'm falling off a cliff.
Put the seat down a little bit. Back. Yeah, proprietary everything. Not bringing this on a tour. And of course, because I busted out the folding bike, Chris had to bust out the folding bike.
No, I have to get
it. Because he's got to get this one sold. Oh, at least it's a chromo. I thought it was aluminum. It's got the grip shifter. 100 off of Craigslist. You were going to use it, but you decided to flip it for 150, 200. I bet you get 200 for it.
I have to get this fender higher though.
And you put new tires on it.
Yeah, it's got some new tires, but
it's sick. But there's a car behind this tree and behind this hand.
Maybe he has. I don't know.
Have you shown anybody the car yet?
Austin, come.
He got a new car. A freaking cool car.
Ready?
This is what the bike looks like in riding mode, and that's what it looks like in transformer mode. All folded up. You just grab it. And you can like go on trains, cars, planes, whatever. This does fit in the overhead compartment of an aeroplane. That was really cool about the Brompton design and geometry. And the frame, they've been using the same frame design since like the 70s. Super cool bike. We're going to the skate park. Chris is gonna drop in.
Hurry in.
No. It's gonna be sick. He's gonna drop in so hard. Let's do it. Right there is like perfect to learn how to drop in. That tiny little quarter. But this is how you drop in. You start on something without any coping. You slam the front down and you just kind of like lean forward and you trust that you're going to be okay.
Yeah, this is hard.
It is. It's so I remember it, dude. There you go. You almost had it. All your weight on the front truck. All your weight on the front. Got it. Got him. Doesn't that feel good? Got it. Easy. All right, we went to the skate park. We didn't film anything except for Chris dropping in. But we're going to a Goodwill. Oh my gosh, this is a super deal on a printer.
Wow.
I think I'm gonna grab this. This is a really, really, really good deal. $12.99, just came out. So new, this sucker's like $1,000. And used, it's like $300. But it has all the toner cartridges. These toners are chipped. But unfortunately, it's got some damages to it. So I'm gonna leave it. because I don't want to be messing with a project printer at Chris's house. It probably prints fine, but something up top with like the feeder, that ribbon cable probably goes to like the feeder, which means it's not gonna be functioning perfect. Therefore, we're gonna pass. I am gonna grab this though. It is a vintage LL Bean earth tones. Got some leather accents, rolling duffel. It's probably worth about 50 bucks, 60 bucks shipped. They're asking, I think it was $4.99, wherever it was. Yeah, $4.99, we're gonna cop this. And I'm gonna use it if it doesn't sell by the time that I leave Austin. So I'll bring this to Florida if it doesn't sell. What is it?
2XU bibs, man. These are pretty cool. 50 plus. They're 8 bucks here.
7 bucks with the coupon. He's gonna sell it for 50 to 100. Oh, we got all the goods. Yeah. We actually went to an Asian supermarket where I did not video anything. And we got a bunch of Asian groceries. Wasabi peas. We got an onion. We got ginger. This is all just like normal stuff, right? Green onions, gluten-free soy sauce. This is what we went for, right here. This ahi tuna, wild caught ahi tuna from Indonesia. Freaking $28 that we're gonna make some poke with. And from what I've heard from people on Instagram ripping me, poke does not have an accent like Pokemon. It's like poke or something like that. If you've ever had jackfruit, this is in season right now and it is absolutely delicious. This is half a jackfruit, 99 cents a pound. So it was just $9.29. Every square millimeter of it is just covered in poke sauce. Right, Peter? Right, Peter? If we can get it to fit. 2 to 3 hours.
Yeah, 2 to 3.
3 hours later.
Dude, the poke is done?
Yeah, I'm behind it.
The poke is done?
Poke is done, man.
Minute rice?
Pretty much.
Uncle Ben's?
Alright, ready? Eric, how much you want?
Dude, as much as I can get.
Alright, like, start off with that.
Start it.
Okay.
Then we got jackfruit.
I'm convinced that you don't know how to cut up an avocado.
Red pepper, nice, tasty.
Good. You try extra salty.
So this is Chris's backyard, whoever wants to see Chris's backyard. Poke was great. Great value, great taste. Thanks everybody for hanging out with us today and watching. I'm gonna try to get back into a habit of picking up the camera, especially while I'm in Austin. We're gonna be doing a lot of fun stuff here. Something kind of interesting happened. I'll go over that tomorrow regarding Patagonia. Like, I've been doing something with Patagonia and I got an email about kind of sour and I'm selling a lot of my Patagonia stuff. So I'll go over that tomorrow, but thanks everybody for watching. If you haven't already, please give the video a thumbs up. If you have any encouraging comments or want to connect with me, the best place is in the comment section or on Instagram. And I will talk to you in the next video, probably tomorrow, because we're gonna be doing a lot of fun stuff in Austin. So